already informed people about MBBS in Russia. This is our next session. Now the NEET result is already declared, and students have options. Mostly the students get confused if we have low NEET marks, what to do. So first of all, I would like to explain the results, what were in all these 3 years, 2018, 19 and 20, NEET is valid. Valid for admissions, valid as per MCI rules, so that students, many students have questions. Sir, mera to 2018 ka NEET hai. And aap dekh rahe hain abhi screen pe, 2018 mein agar general category NEET marks 119 hai, aur SCST 96 hai, to OBC is also 96, so you are qualified for MBBS admissions in Russia. Similarly, 2019 is mentioned 134 for general category, 107 for SCST and 107 for OBC. 2020, 147 and 113 is the NEET cutoff, and 113 for OBC as well. काफी बच्चे ये confused रहते हैं और उनको ये information दी जाती है कि NEET के marks जो हैं वो high चाहिए Russia के admissions के लिए. No, not at all. Admissions in universities which we represent, and we represent more than 14 universities of Russia, being one of the larger groups of Russia, for the MBBS admissions. At the moment, 3,000 students are studying in those universities which we represent in, from India, and more than 10,000 are passed out from India, of course. So since 1991, or you can say even since 1989 is my experience, almost 30 years, we are involved in admissions from 32 countries of the world. We have a St. Petersburg office, we have a office branch office in Moscow, and we have a headquarters in India in New Delhi. At the moment, I'm in connect with you from the headquarters of Delhi. So these are the marks for which you are already eligible, and you can take an admission in those universities which we represent. So your marks will not be considered low, because all those universities which we represent have a certain eligibility criteria. That is the same what MCI has. MCI has eligible criteria of PCB 50% aggregate and NEET qualified. Similarly to for SC, OBC, it's 45. So you are eligible for the same what you get in, really sorry, got a little confused. All students, those who achieved cutoff marks in NEET in 18, 19 and 20, and students who received marks as per the MCI eligibility are eligible for admissions in our universities. This is the main criteria students should understand. If anybody informs them that you need 300, 500, no, it is not actually like that. It might be that some universities have their local test. Yes, if you pass that local test, then you might be eligible for that university. There are some certain strict universities which need a test. So MBBS in Russia, already more than 40 years students are going for MBBS in Russia. Today, one student called me and had a very interesting question that are doctors able to get after MBBS in Russia the government jobs? Of course, yes. After you complete your MBBS in Russia, you come to India and give a next exam, national exit test. After next, you get a license. Of course, you do the internship as well. And then you are eligible for any jobs, because you are same, because you are exactly the same doctor as in India. The only difference is that your exposure will be even more because you have studied in Russia. Some questions are regarding Russia. What is Russia? So Russia is one of the biggest country, one of the scientific superpowers of the world, and almost 17 million area, of course, the largest country of the world, having 146 million people. I'll be very short today because long webinars are very, very difficult for the students. So what are the plus points of study MBBS in Russia is you don't need any entrance test. Means at least in those universities which will be showing ahead, just it's a test that you give formal test because you know English, so they should understand that you understand English. They understand that you have completed your 12th class basics. And easy admission procedure, it's very easy because you do only give us your medical certificates, your passport, your mark sheets, and your photographs. Rest, everything is done by us, by Go Studies Abroad. Go Studies Abroad is an Indian organization which is based in New Delhi. We have many agencies, of course, all over India, but due to lockdown, they are not all, they all are, means some are working, some are not. So why Russia for MBBS is also very important for students. There are government hospitals, government universities, where you will be taught, of course, all the universities are MCI listed, WHO recognized, WDOMS, which is World Directory of Medical Schools, all are listed there as well. Once again, all the universities of Russia, which we represent, are the government universities. Benefits of MBBS in Russia for Indian is, first of all, I would say it is my personal experience that your exposure is very, very high. You are studying in a Europeanized country. First of all, you learn a language. Some people think why to learn a language. This is a very plus point because there are so many diplomats in India. There are so many businessmen in India. Those who are regularly traveling to India. So many tourists in India. So if you're working in a hospital and you know Russian language, which is almost spoken by 350 million people. 350 million people speak Russian language. So it's a plus point for you if you know that language. And of course, our universities don't teach you in Russian language. Only the practicals you require in Russian to be done. That is obviously, except five countries, everywhere you need to do the hospital, the patient interactions in the Russian language. So European standard universities, European standard living, obviously all the universities are government universities. And all the hospitals where you practice as well are the government hospitals. This is a very important part when you study in Russia. Now, going to a next step, benefits of MBBS in Russia, I've already explained. Yeah. Let's go to the next slide now. This is one of the universities which we represent, Tambov State Medical University. This has it's a part of Tambov State University. State Medical is a part of that. And almost 12,000 students are studying in Tambov State University. And in medical, approximately, I think from India, there are 500 students from India. Yeah, there are 500 students from India studying in this university. It's a small city. The university was founded in 1918. And hostels are government hostels. Universities, obviously, also government universities. 790 professors. All professors are PhD professors, those who will be teaching. 15 years the university is already teaching in English medium. This is very important. MCI coaching is available in this university. It is an important fact. Of course, it is optional for the students and they can join or they don't want. They don't want. They cannot join. Means it's not mandatory for us and for them as well. Astrakhan State University. Sorry, one more thing very important that in Tambov State Medical University, you'll be very near to Moscow. Just 400 and something kilometers. It's one of the nearest universities which we have. Of course, not talking about inside Moscow, Sechenova University. I'm talking about Tambov. And you can travel very easily to Moscow. The trains are comfortable. If you want to go just as a tourist to Moscow or St. Petersburg, it's not so far as well. Astrakhan University is in Astrakhan city. It's very famous for its dentistry and MBBS. Many German, Spanish, and other European citizens are studying in this university. This university is also a third university out of 48 universities. Ministry of Health and Education have given a grant to this university at third university in international studies in Russia, means third ranking. Mostly we don't go on rankings because studies everywhere are same. So this is also a point maybe somebody sometimes asks what is the ranking and all. That's why just I'm giving a general information. So it is about Astrakhan University and almost 1,000. It's of course, there are 6,100 students studying over there. This university is also part of Astrakhan State University and the medical university has a huge, huge setup over there, including they have many, many hospitals. And this university is a really, really large university. The city is also far more bigger than Tambov. But it's far away from Moscow. You have to take a one-hour flight. The plus point of Astrakhan is located on the beach. Means it's near the sea. And it is very comfortable for the weather, very comfortable. By chance, suppose if somebody wants only the weather like Mumbai or something related to this, the weather is over there is similar to Mumbai. If to talk about Saratov University, approximately it's also 1.5 hour flight to Saratov, one and a half hour flight to Saratov. This is also very big, very huge university, part of state university. The medical university is part of the state university. Saratov is a city, of course, also bigger than Tambov. It's even bigger than Astrakhan if you talk about the number of people living there, population, I mean to say, and the area. And Saratov University has started the English medium, and Astrakhan University as well has started the English medium almost 10 years or more, even more than 10 years. So this is very, very important for you to understand that we have already the universities which are more than 10 years, many batches have passed out, many MCI students are cleared, 95% result is of Tambov University because they have a coaching as well. These are important things for students because they are worried about this. So about the NEET, I have told what is the eligibility, about the percentage eligibility, about the universities. Let's come to how to submit an application. It's a very easy process. When we send you the university's PDF presentations, we also brochures, we also send you a form. This form is very easy to fill. What actually the form is about, that you have to just mention some of your details, and you have to mention your ID number or whatever, means passport. If you have passport, you can mention your passport number. If you don't have a passport, you can mention your Aadhaar card number, and you have to mention some of your parents' details, email. We can help you with a sample form as well if you need to fill a form, and seeing another form of other student, we have them as well, not at all a problem. So one more important thing is that you don't need any IELTS, TOEFLs, any test regarding specialized in English or very high what you call it, the rating of English you should have, or high marks in English. No, that is not required for the admissions in Russia in MBBS. This is very important. So now if we go to a next step, of course, it's almost a September intake, but we'll be sending the students in November after Diwali. As soon as the flights start, we'll be getting the visas for them. Flights, I mean, flights from Delhi or Mumbai or Chennai to Russia. So now coming to a next step, and next slide, total processing fee with visa guarantee. Obviously, we take a total fee of in India of 1,25,000 rupees plus GST. 25,000 rupees is kind of a token money which you pay us so that we can get you an admission letter, plus we can start your formalities, because we have to translate your ID, we have to translate your mark sheet. Then later on, what we do is that when you give us your passport, we get it translated, we get an invitation done from the university. We do A to Z. Once it's a one-stop solution, of course, because we take care of you. Go Studies Abroad is taking care of the students in India as well for all the documentation A to Z. And our representative offices in St. Petersburg or Moscow are taking care of all the issues which arise in the university or which arise in the country of Russia. So we are here so that you have a one window. Your parents can talk only with Go Studies Abroad, and we'll be discussing with our team. So it's one team which is very, very comfortable for everybody. We have also mentioned if somebody has some doubt, we have also mentioned our addresses of Petersburg or Moscow in the website. They can go through that as well. Here also it is mentioned, because some people ask, where are you located, in Moscow or St. Petersburg? We mention it as well, so that nobody has any doubts. So if you have any questions, you can write me the questions. I am ready to answer. Ayush, Nikunj, Nidhi, Dilpreet, I can answer your questions. I tried to provide everybody a short information. Nikita, do you have any questions? Dhanashri, maybe you have any questions? Ayush, Asif, you can write your questions. I'm seeing the dashboard. I can answer them, all your doubts. वी कैन ऑल्सो अरेंज वेब काउंसलिंग और जूम काउंसलिंग इफ रिक्वायर्ड. वी कैन आंसर योर क्वेश्चंस इंडिविजुअली एज वेल. सो इफ एवरीथिंग इज क्लियर यू मे सेलेक्ट some one of the universities and send us the form and we can start your procedure. We are providing a $500 grant to the students scholarship, which is a one-time scholarship in first year. It is approximately 40,000 rupees. For this we have certain numbers which are still pending, so you have a chance to get 40,000 rupees scholarship for the first year. This is a plus point also, because overall it will be maybe in another 2-3 days it will be stopped, because admissions are going to complete, the seats will be finished soon. Admissions are going on daily, we are getting the forms daily. What if we are not able to clear the MCA exam? Actually MCA exam doesn't has that you can only attempt once. First of all, you can attempt many times, first of all. Second thing, if you are not able to clear MCA exam, you have an option. Of course, it is abroad option. You can easily study, first of all, your bachelor's degree, it is valid worldwide. It is valid for United States of Medical License exam. It is valid for PLAB in London. But I have not heard yet even a single candidate who has not cleared the MCI exams after 2 or 3 attempts. So MCI attempts are unlimited. So how many times you want to attend, you should of course be prepared. If you want to study, you will be able to pass. I'm dead sure. Yes, you will get a student loan, of course. Yeah, so there is a question that will I get a student loan for studying there? Yes, of course you will get a student loan. We provide the offer letter and everything and the invoices from the university, and on the base of that already the students have got the student loan. Those who have already received the letters, some have applied for the loan and they already got the loans. So this is also, this is easily available. There is a website in India, vidyapeeth.in. You can apply there for a loan as well. We will send you the link if required. Criteria for the scholarship? No, at the moment we don't have any criteria for the scholarship. There are certain numbers of scholarship students which is available, $500 as I told you. First come first serve. As soon as the number of students is completed, the scholarships will not be provided. For the scholarship you have to remit the fees to the university till 25th of October, and you have to fill the form within coming 2-3 days, because later on the scholarships will be null and void, not valid. Next exam has to be given after completing the course. Yes, after you complete the course of 5.8 years, you will come in India and you will be able to give the next exam, national exit test. So any other questions? Let me see all the questions I have answered. Can you talk to my parents and make them understand? Of course I can talk to the parents, and we have a numbers on the dashboard at the moment, Indian in numbers in India. We can talk to your parents and discuss and explain them that no need to worry about that your student will be studying abroad. Even if it is a girl, it is a safest, one of the safest country with very, very less low crime rate, and students are very, very safe over there. Even what we can do is that your parents can talk to the students or to the parents which are already studying over there. Students which are already studying there and parents which have already students studying in our university, so that they can also provide some confidence to your parents. So please leave your numbers if you want that. You have our we can get in touch with you. We have all your details, so we can talk with your parents as well. They try 3 to 4 times and then you don't get seat. Which seat? Sorry, I'm not able to understand. Ayush. Who tried 3-4 times and then they don't get seat? आयुष, यस ऑफ कोर्स, 112 यूएस यू कैन गो अब्रैड अब्रॉड आसिफ, बट योर डिग्री विल नॉट बी वैलिड फॉर एमसीआई बिकॉज एमसीआई एलिजिबिलिटी, आर यू अ जनरल कैटेगरी? इफ फॉर जनरल कैटेगरी इट इज 147 एंड इफ फॉर ओबीसी एससी इट इज 113. सो इफ यू हैव 112 यू कैन गो अब्रॉड, यू कैन स्टडी, बट यू हैव टू देन कंप्लीट योर पीजी देयर एंड देन यू हैव टू कंप्लीट ऑल योर स्टडीज देयर एंड गेट अ प्लेसमेंट ओवर देयर बिकॉज फॉर एमसीआई यू विल नॉट बी एलिजिबल. सेकेंड पार्ट इज दिस ईयर फॉर दिस ईयर स्टूडेंट्स इज गुड दैट यू कैन गेट योर रोल नंबर, आस्क योर पेरेंट्स टू गेट द रोल नंबर, कम बैक टू इंडिया इन मे. We have already discussed with the universities that you will get holidays of 10 days. Give your NEET exam once again because in any case your coaching is online, so you can give your NEET exams once again. And if your NEET is qualified next year, for sure you are eligible for MCI as well. So if you are not sure about the NEET exam, then you can get a placement in Russia because you will complete your degree over there. But for Russia, you have to complete the PG as well. It is total 6 plus 3. So you have to study 9 years so that you are a MD, specialized doctor. Yeah, I got your point. Yes, still you can go to Russia, but then you have to take a placement in Russia if you will not be able to qualify NEET, or you have a possibility to qualify NEET next year. I think there was a question by a. मैं थोड़ा सा हिंदी में भी बोल देता हूँ आसिफ, अगर आपको आई थिंक सबको समझ तो आ ही रहा है, लेकिन स्टिल मैं थोड़ी बहुत चीजें हिंदी में भी बता देता हूँ कि 112 अगर मार्क्स हैं आप बाहर जा सकते हैं, आप टोटल एमडी कीजिए रशिया से और रशिया में ही प्लेसमेंट लीजिए, वहीं पर ही जॉब कीजिए. ऑफकोर्स वहां पर भी डॉक्टर्स की कमी है और जॉब्स की कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, आपको जॉब तो गारंटेड है. अगर आप वहां पे एमबीबीएस और एमडी कंप्लीट करते हैं आपकी जॉब गारंटीड है, आपको हंसी खुशी वहां पे हॉस्पिटल में जॉब मिलती है, परमानेंट गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल में भी मिल जाएगी बिकॉज आपने गवर्नमेंट यूनिवर्सिटी से अपना एमबीबीएस और एमडी किया है जो कि वहां की मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड एजुकेशन रिकॉग्नाइज करती है. और आपको वहां पर कोई टेस्ट भी नहीं देना है, मतलब जैसे इंडिया में आके आपको एमसीए का टेस्ट देना है तो रशिया के लिए आपको लोकल कोई टेस्ट नहीं देना है. आप अगर अपनी पूरी पढ़ाई करते रहते हैं और नॉर्मल एग्जाम्स देते रहते हैं तो यू आर क्वालिफाइड, दैट्स ऑल. आपको 9 साल के बाद लाइसेंस मिल जाता है नंबर, क्योंकि आपने एमडी कर ली है. सेटअप इन रशिया का क्या मतलब? मतलब आप मींस यू वांट टू स्टे आफ्टर योर स्टडीज इन रशिया. यस, आप जब अपनी पीजी कर लेंगे टोटल 9 ईयर्स, उसके बाद आपको पहली बात तो आपको वहां का पीआर मिल जाएगा, परमानेंट रेजिडेंस. उसके 2 साल के बाद अप्रोक्सीमेटली आपको सिटीजनशिप मिल जाएगी. आप सिटीजन हो गए तो आप एक रशियन सिटीजन हो गए, इंडियन बॉर्न हुए लेकिन रशियन सिटीजन हो गए. अगर आप पीआर पे ही वहां पर रहना चाहते हैं हमेशा, वो भी कर सकते हैं. जॉब तो आपको मिली गई ना, मेन तो ये है कि आपको डॉक्टर बनने के बाद आपको जॉब मिल जाएगी, आपकी जॉब शुरू हो गई. अब आप चाहे पीआर पे रहिए, परमानेंट रेजिडेंस पे रहिए, या फिर आप अपनी सिटीजनशिप अप्लाई कर दीजिए, आपके लिए दोनों चीजें पॉसिबल होती है. नेक्स्ट एग्जाम, हाँ आपने कोर्स कोर्स कंप्लीट होने के बाद ही देना है. मैंने यह आंसर किया था ऑलरेडी, नेक्स्ट का एग्जाम कोर्स कंप्लीट होने के बाद देना.
एमबीबीएस हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स?
एमबीबीएस के कितने स्टूडेंट? तंबोव में 500 स्टूडेंट हैं, सरातव में 200 हैं, अस्त्रखंड में भी अप्रोक्सीमेटली 150-200 हैं. इंडिया से मैं बता रहा हूँ, ओवरऑल तो बहुत ज्यादा है. आई एम टॉकिंग ओनली द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स दोज हू आर फ्रॉम इंडिया. नहीं, जरूरी नहीं है कि रशिया में रहने के लिए रशियन नेशनलिटी जरूरी है, नहीं कोई जरूरी नहीं है. आप इंडियन नेशनल की तरह वहां रह सकते हैं. आप जब कंप्लीट कर लेंगे अपनी पढ़ाई पूरे 9 साल, तो इजिली आप 9 साल के बाद आपको पीआर मिलता है क्योंकि आपकी जॉब कंफर्म है ऑब्वियसली, इसलिए आपको पीआर मिल जाएगा. तो आप परमानेंट रेजिडेंस की तरह रहिए. आज की डेट में मैं भी एक परमानेंट रेजिडेंट हूँ. अभी तक मुझे 29 ईयर्स हो गए हैं रशिया में रहते हुए. मैंने सिटीजनशिप रशियन नहीं ली है, मैं इंडियन सिटीजन हूँ लेकिन मेरे पास रशिया का परमानेंट रेजिडेंटशिप है. मतलब मैं वहां हर 5 साल उसको एक्सटेंड कराता हूँ, दैट्स ऑल. 5 साल में एक बार वो एक्सटेंशन मिलती है और वो एक्सटेंशन भी इजी है, फॉर्मेलिटी है, आपको डॉक्यूमेंट देने हैं, जहां आपकी जॉब है उसका डिक्लेरेशन देना है, दैट्स ऑल। यस इट इज परफेक्ट, आप अप्लाई कर सकते हैं। आप हमारा फॉर्म भर के, हाँ या सॉरी आई हैव स्कोर्ड 151 एंड आई बिलोंग टू ओबीसी कैटेगरी, इज दैट ओके? यस इट इज वेरी वेरी परफेक्ट, यू हैव ऑलरेडी क्वालिफाइड द नीट, सो दिस इज 151 इज इन नीट आई होप, सो यू कैन अप्लाई। आप हमारा फॉर्म भरिए, सॉरी देर आर सम साउथ इंडियन स्टूडेंट्स एज वेल, आई विल स्पीक इन इंग्लिश, सो यस ऑफ कोर्स इट इज फाइन, यू कैन फिल द फॉर्म एंड सेंड इट टू अस, इफ रिक्वायर्ड वी कैन हैव अ ऑनलाइन जूम सेशन ऑफ काउंसलिंग एंड देन वी कैन गो अहेड विद योर फॉर्मेलिटीज, इफ एवरीथिंग इज अंडरस्टूड देन यू कैन सेंड अस अ फॉर्म एंड वील स्टार्ट द एडमिशन प्रोसीजर।
They want, if they have any other questions or they want to talk, if they want their parents to talk to us, they can send us a message on WhatsApp.
Yeah, so you can send us a message on WhatsApp. My right hand, my marketing guy is helping me out a little. His name is Manan. So our WhatsApp is 9198709, is the code of India, 9870263138. It is on the dashboard. Send us your WhatsApp mark sheet on WhatsApp and we will carry on the, we will start the procedure of your admissions or we'll reply to all your answers. So most welcome. Where, how much salary you get in Russia? Can you tell nearly how much salary we can get? So it depends upon your abilities. There is a different salary package. For example, I have my friends, those who are doctors, they are getting approximately 200,000 local currency. It is almost same to India. So they are getting 200,000. For example, my wife is a doctor. She's working only 3 days a week and she's getting 110,000. This is in Moscow. If you are in a small city, your expenses are less. Of course, then you will get the salary is also less. But average salary, if you are working 5 days a week and you are a good doctor, it is something around 60-70,000. Yes, there are multiple. Are there multiple chances for next exam? Of course, there are. There are multiple chances for next exam, so don't worry about next exam. Moreover, I recommend to fill the form of Tambov University because those who are worried about next exam, they can get a next coaching. 19 subjects are taught in that coaching, and the passing rate is 95%. This is very important for you. Means select the University of Tambov. That will give you a plus point to clear your next exam as well. In third course, you can take MCI coaching, which is offline come online both. It is not only online, for your information, it is very important. All college brochures on WhatsApp. Yes, we can send. Yes,
Send us.
send us a message on WhatsApp and your mark sheet, and we'll send all brochures on your WhatsApp. For citizenship, what you have to do after you get a PR, you can apply for a citizenship. Main criteria for citizenship that it is that are you working over there? First, you should have a job over there. Second thing, you will now it is very important that you know the language. Obviously, after 9 years of studies in MBBS and MD and working in hospitals, you are very, very perfect. You will be very, very perfect in language. So these are the main two things. And of course, you don't have any criminal records. This is the third thing. So if you have these two things, I mean to say main, that you know the language and you have a job, of course you will have a job because you are a doctor. So you can apply for the citizenship after you get your PR. After PR, 2 years it will take. Yes, 118 SC category. Can I go? Yes, you can, of course. You are qualified. So you can again send us your mark sheet on WhatsApp. We can send you the brochure and you can fill the form and you can take admissions. They are still going on. Of course, very less days are left for the admissions. Please hurry. Please hurry. Hurry up. so that you don't lose your 1 year if you are qualified. Because I don't see any facts of if you have 118, 120, 131, means if you are passed, if you are NEET qualified, MCI eligible, please go ahead with your admissions. इंडिया के बारे में हमें सर क्या मैं इंडिया से बी ए एम एस कर सकता हूँ? आई एम वेरी सॉरी बट वी डोंट हैव इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द बी ए एम एस इन इंडिया. सॉरी डियर, आई कैन नॉट हेल्प यू विद दिस क्वेश्चन. इफ एनी क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग रशिया, वहाँ का कोई क्वेश्चन है तो बताइए. इंडिया के बी एम एस या एम बी बी एस के बारे में हमें इतनी इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं है. सारे क्वेश्चंस आंसर हो गए
हैं.
और कोई क्वेश्चंस हैं? अदरवाइज वी विल क्लोज द सेशन. आप हमें व्हाट्सएप पे मार्कशीट भेजिए. 118 क्वालिफाइड है, 151 क्वालिफाइड है. क्वालिफाइड मार्क्स एक बार स्लाइड दोबारा से दिखा देते हैं हम आपको क्वालिफाइड मार्क्स की. ये स्लाइड है क्वालिफाइड मार्क्स की. जनरल कैटेगरी के लिए 2020 में अगर आपने नीट दिया है तो 96 अगर हम जनरल कैटेगरी की बात करते हैं 2020 की 147, अगर हम बात करते हैं एस सी एस टी एंड ओबीसी 113. अगर आपके ये नीट में मार्क्स हैं तो आपका एडमिशन हो सकता है. आप हमारे को कांटेक्ट कीजिए, अपनी मार्कशीट भेजिए एंड हम आपकी फॉर्मेलिटी स्टार्ट करेंगे. मैं रिपीट कर रहा हूँ कि आपके पास टाइम बहुत कम है बिकॉज हमारे कुछ स्टूडेंट्स के लेसन ऑलरेडी 1st of November से 3rd of November से स्टार्ट हो रहे हैं, ग्रुप बनने शुरू हो गए हैं. सो प्लीज प्लीज स्टार्ट योर प्रोसीजर एज सून एज पॉसिबल. ओके गाइस, थैंक यू वेरी मच. निकुल थैंक यू वेरी मच. आसिफ थैंक यू. जो भी आपके क्वेश्चन है मैंने पूरी कोशिश करी कि मैं जल्दी से जल्दी आंसर करूँ. We have some now counseling sessions on this thing. Nikita, thank you so much. Shivani, thank you. Everybody, thank you to everybody. Bye-bye.